So welcome back. In this video, we'll complete the objective 2 and objective 3 of our case study. Objective 2 is to summarize the data, which is to calculate the total volume, total cost, total sales value and total profit for all the years. And objective 3 being edit these summarized data. So okay, you can make two macros or you can just make it one macro and perform both the objectives in one go. Basically, I need to calculate the total cost, which is the total of this particular column, total sales, which is total of this particular sales column, total volume, and I need to find the total profit, which is obviously total sales minus the total cost columns. So I'll start with my record macro feature. Try doing it yourself first and then come back to my video and then again see how I have done and I have made recorded the macro. Try first of all, try doing it yourself. Okay, so I'll start my macro. Obviously we'll use relative referencing, and suppose I'm placing my cursor in L7 and then I'll start recording the macro. Make sure you place your cursor where you want to start writing so that it's easier for you all to record the macro and execute the same. I'll click on record macro. Let's make it the name summarization, and let's give the shortcut as shift and E. Okay, shift and E, yeah, and let's give the description as to summarize the data. So I'll just click on OK, and once I click on OK, it will get changed to stop recording option, and I'm clicking OK. This has changed. I'll write summary. Okay, I've written summary in L7. I'll move down using the keyboard only. Don't use the mouse. Total volume, down arrow. Total sales, down arrow. Total cost, down arrow. And total profit. Yeah, so I've written all my data which I need to get. In the total volume, I'm using my keyboard only, equal to sum, open bracket. Now generally what we do is we go to the volume column, click on this particular cell and use shift control down to select the entire column. Now again the same error will appear. Once you select the entire column using shift control down arrow, what will happen only till the rows which are there over in this particular sheet, which is 3481, only till that row it will get selected. And so what will happen in the next sheets, what will happen is that when you perform this macro, when you execute this macro, each time only 3481 rows will be recorded and will be executed, and for the same the sum will be calculated, whereas we need to calculate the sum for the all rows. So instead of selecting only these particular cells using control shift down arrow, which we usually do, what we'll do is I'll select the entire column. So I'll click on F. I'll click on the F so that the entire column gets selected, and you all can see it has changed to FF. So what happens, the entire column gets selected. So my in all other years where I have different row numbers, for that my sum will come as accurate. And if you do this by selecting control shift down arrow and selecting the entire column, which we have done in our Excel videos, if you do that, what will happen is that only those particular rows will be recorded in your code, and each time when you perform, only that many rows will be calculated. So I want to calculate for the entire column, so I'll select the F because I don't have anything else below my table. I just have this particular table, so my answer will be correct. And I'll close the bracket, enter. Now the same I'll do for sales sum, and in this case I'll select the entire jth column, close my bracket, enter. Sum, open bracket. Yes, I'm using my mouse for selecting the row. Close bracket. Now how to calculate the total profit? It is obviously sales, which is M9, minus cost using my keyboard only. You can use your mouse, but it's better because over here I can use my mouse to scroll up and down. Just for selecting the columns, I have used my mouse over here. Click on enter and you have calculated your total profit figure. Now the next step is to edit. So not showing so much of creativity, I've selected these two cells, home tab, merge and center, can make it bold, can make all these cells bold, and can maybe change the color. So this is how I have done my editing. This is it. I don't want to edit it more. If you want, you can add rupees symbol to the total sales and total cost cells, but it's better if you do it like this. It's not a big deal. It's up to you. This is how I have recorded the macro. Click on the stop recording macro button, which you can see over here. And this is how I've completed the recording of my macro. To check whether it has been recorded appropriately or not, we'll do it for other sheets, other years as well. So from where did I start my macro? It was L7. The active cell should be L7 whenever I execute this particular macro. So I'll go to L7. Developer tab, macros, summarization, run. And see, your macro has been successfully calculated. So while editing, you could have adjusted the column size also. So you don't have to adjust it all the time. So while editing, while I was editing these particular cells, after that, you could have simply adjusted the column size as well. That would also have been recorded in your macro. So anything you do will be recorded in a macro. So that feature which I forgot to do, you should do it while recording the macro, which is adjusting your column size as well. So you don't have to do it once you execute the macro. Same thing I'll do for 2013. I'll go to cell number L7. My shortcut key was Control Shift E, and see how I've recorded the macro. It's always better. I also could have included my adjusting column feature in my macro as well, L7. Control Shift E, and see how my entire summary has been populated. So this is how I've performed a simple, very simple case study on how to record a macro. New features which we learned was Control D. We saw if you used fill handle, if you used Control Shift up while calculating the volume, total volume, the error would have cropped up because the entire column would not have been selected because the row numbers are not same for each year. So when I was recording it for 2011, maybe only till 3481 rows would have been taken for all other sheets as well, which would have made my calculations wrong. So I selected the entire column instead for accuracy. And this is how I get my answers. Please practice it. We'll develop on our skills more. This was the easiest assignment which I could have find for you all, because this is the starting of macros, and I hope you're enjoying it, because if you don't enjoy doing this, you'll not be able to learn. So try enjoying what you do. This is very simple, very easy, very interesting, and makes work very, very simple. Thank you for this class, and we'll continue with the macros from the next class onwards. Thank you.